EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the world's steel capital in the city of bridges, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and Acrisure Stadium. But tonight, we've got a good AFC matchup on tap, as it'll be the New York Jets taking on the Pittsburgh Steelers. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. Here's Wilson to throw right away. And the Jets pressure too much as down he goes. C.J. Mosley, the linebacker, making sure his presence is felt.
Okay, partner, a couple points of interest right here, all right? Offensively, we see that they came out throwing the football, but maybe more importantly, the blitz that came defensively, they got right after him.
And you were telling me pregame, before we came on air, you think this is something we could see a lot.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it.
Under pressure again, and down he goes again. The former third overall pick, Quinnen Williams, there to bring him down. Boy, how about this to start a ball game? That's twice in a row now, Charles, that they get to him.
And how often do we talk about offenses that operate off of a script to begin games? Feels like this defense had their script together on this one, and their script said put the quarterback down and do it fast.
Throw left side, hauled in by Pickens. It's a gain of 6, but not enough, as he'll be forced to punt on their first drive of the game.
Well, we hear so often how tackling has become almost a lost art in the NFL game, but it's so important to tackle well on these receivers, especially in a play like this one. Third down, they gave him the underneath stuff. You got to go up and make the tackle right away.
On is the punter, Johnston, now as he sends this one away. Now a fair catch signaled for and made right about the 43-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt. And the Jets will take over. Good starting position for the Jets as they come up first and 10 at their own 43. Rodgers gonna throw. And a little floater there is incomplete.
And I could see the officials kind of looking at each other down there, silently wondering, does this meet the level of grounding? Fortunately, he did have a receiver in the area, but I have seen less obvious throwaways called as penalties.
Now a second and 10. Rodgers now to throw. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football, and it's picked up by the Steelers. And he takes it back to the house. A fumble recovery for a Steelers score. And Charles, look at the big fella. What a rumble that was. Not only to scoop it, but then take it the rest of the way for the touchdown.
And now you know they're going to have to hear about it from now on. The defensive backs, he's going to want to run with them, do their drills, the whole deal. He thinks he's the pace setter now.
It doesn't matter what happens in practice this week, he's smiling. Extra point put through by Boswell, and that makes the score 7-0. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. Back onto the field come the New York Jets for their second drive. Rodgers now on first down. Able to complete this one to Tyler Conklin. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31.
The completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught and you don't give up much run after the catch.
They'll come up now second and four from the 31. Now it's Rodgers. Quick hitter here, it's complete. His first catch, good for nine and a first down.
They kept the receiver in the short field, but that let his quarterback get the ball quickly to him before either guy in double coverage could react.
On first down, Rodgers. Open man here is Conklin. That's good. The completion there for 7 yards, and that will bring up second down.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now it brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. From the 46, here's second down and three. Here's Rodgers. And this throw incomplete. Now the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down.
Not a great start dropping his first target, but let's face it, it won't be his last chance because he'll get opportunities to make up for that one throughout this game.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three. Throwing is Rodgers. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And they're going to have themselves another first down as the tackle's made at the Steelers 43. The jet passing game in rhythm. They've got another first. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
Nice progress down the field was halted by that incompletion. They could try for some safe yards here to get things moving again or keep throwing it and pushing it downfield to try and pick up bigger yardage.
First carry for the Iowa State man, Breece Hall. And he takes it down to the 40 with a pickup of four.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That was a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
So it's third and six, and this will be the eighth play of the drive. To throw is Rodgers. Oh, this will be incomplete. The rush gets home just as he was letting that go. That could have been worse. Instead, it's fourth down.
They're bringing a lot of pressure here already in the first quarter. Already sacked him once. Now they get in there and knock another one away. You think maybe that tuck rule being gone makes defenses a lot bolder?
Yes, indeed. That time, lucky that the arm was going forward. Incomplete pass. And here's Morstead now as he sends this one away. And they'll play keep away from the returner as this one will be marked out of bounds at the 13-yard line. Pretty good spot. So Pittsburgh retakes the field for their second offensive possession. They've got a 7-0 lead in the football as well as they start out first and 10. Harris starts the drive on the ground, and he'll power ahead, but only for about 3 yards. Second down coming up.
It may be only a gain of 3 yards, but that back, he deserves a lot more credit on the play. That could have easily been stopped at the line, but his vision and his determination found some space to turn it into that modest gain.
And they'll come up second and 7. To throw is Wilson. He's got Watkins on the out route, and he'll take this across the 25 before going out of bounds. His first catch of the game, good for 11 and a first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good, and it's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down, drive keeps moving.
And he powers his way up past the 30. And give him 4 yards there, it'll be second and 6. Defensively, they had that one pretty well figured out.
Yeah, one of the things about this play, it can be even more effective when you run a lot of motion And there's plenty of times you don't hand it off.
Second and six. Now it's Wilson. He finds his man complete. It's Watkins. That one, a first down pickup of eight.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Now Wilson. Got an open man. It's Pickens. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. The passing game in rhythm right now for Pittsburgh. There's another first down.
Well, they obviously red man coverage their partner, and he got downfield, broke down the defender, made him
think. What do you mean by that?
He made him think he was going to run a different route. Probably thought he was going to take it upfield, and then he curls back inside for the completion.
Now they fake the jet sweep there and a run instead with Harris.
And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Second quarter action from Pittsburgh. It is the Steelers in control of the football as they've got it with a second and 10. Now run straight ahead with Warren.
And good penetration here. He'll get this down only to about the 49-yard line.
The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of one there.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
On third down, Wilson. And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds, so a big call there that brings up fourth.
Nice call by the defense there on third down. Just flood the field with extra defensive backs in their dime package. Nowhere to go with the football. Forces the incompletion.
Now on fourth down, it's Cameron Johnston on to punt it away. His first punt, 48 yards. This one looks equally as good. And that one hits a little too close to the goal line, and it continues into the end zone for a touchback.
New York ready to go again offensively.
The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
And partner, to me, that one was all about timing. If he's there too early, it's going to be a pass interference call. If he's too late, it's a completed pass. He was Johnny on the spot on that one.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Throwing now is Rodgers. It's complete to Williams. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of three. So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. Throwing is Rodgers on third down. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. A good pickup there, a 22. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
And he'll be brought down at the 50 after a gain of about five.
I really like the vision he displayed on that play because he saw there wasn't a lane to completely break off a huge gain, so he found where there was the most space and got what he could.
A nice dirty run that's a positive play for the offense.
In motion right, that's Wilson.
Oh, they'll run it here on the jet sweep.
Oh, and this one, it may need to go back to the drawing board. He's going to be swallowed up right away.
They'll wind up losing three, and now it's third down.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because, let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
Now Rodgers. And that is incomplete.
It's going to be another frustrating end to a drive here. This offense, they've not been able to get anything going in this first half. And now it's going to be time to gather on the sidelines and try to figure out what's going wrong. Who has an idea? Who has a plan? Time to implement it.
Here's Thomas Morstead on now to punt it away on fourth down. Out comes the Steeler offense now, ready to see what they can do here.
Yeah, they've got themselves a 7-0 lead here, but that, you recall, was a defensive touchdown, so still nothing as of yet for this offense.
Well, they're happy to have the lead. We've got to cut them a little bit of slack. It's still early enough, just a couple of drives so far, but if this one goes nowhere, those adjustments that we talk about, they shouldn't wait for halftime. They should go ahead and start working on them right now.
And they'll get 8 out of this before being stopped at the 28.
Good yardage there on first down, exactly what you want. Get yourself set up to keep making first downs, keep the clock running. And if they're smart, you're starting to milk the clock. No hurry before you run your second down play.
Line of scrimmage, the 28 now, as they come up on second and a couple. They'll keep it on the ground. Harris again. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Second and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down, keep the sticks moving.
Now Wilson on first down. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Pat Freiermuth, the intended target.
And now it's second down. Throwing is Wilson. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Wilson. He'll get only 3 there, so it leaves him with a 3rd and 7 ahead.
Well, that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
Here's Wilson to throw.
Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he will have a Steelers first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
That's a play that will likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
Now a 1st down carry for Harris. And down to the 44, 5 yards that time.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Coming up to the line, and they will need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. On 2nd down, Wilson. He'll be taken down. The Jets get in there for the sack.
That time, multiple defenders getting pressure, and it's a loss of 6.
From midfield now, here's Wilson. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's 4th down.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
He'll get off a fairly short kick here as this is toward the sideline. And now where will the side judge stop his walk? That's the question. He says it crossed out of bounds at about the 17-yard line. And New York set to take the field.
As we eke closer and closer to intermission, Charles, remember last time out they punted. They would love to get points here, especially if this is going to be their final possession of the first half.
Yeah, and this is what close games feel like because the pressure is on both sides, but sometimes the pressure is a little bit higher on the team with the slight edge because they're trying to hold on to that, trying to increase it. Let's see how this one continues.
So 8 yards on the completion there, and that'll bring up a second down in just a couple. And it's a rush to the line right now for the Jets. Rodgers to throw on second down. Pressure comes and down he goes. Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
Still needing 10 yards. Now it's third down. Straight ahead is Hall.
And he'll lose yardage here. Back to the 15. The Steelers signal for the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Now the veteran Thomas Morstead on to punt it away. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Taking it about the 36.
So a good punt there, but a nice return of 11 yards.
And the Steelers will go on offense here, first and 10. Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out onto the field. So far, they've had three drives, three punts. Not good.
Not good indeed, because you've got to have something to show for being out on the field. Now, sometimes, if you have a game where neither side has scored, three punts isn't a bad thing. But when you're trying to set the pace, get up on top in a game, you've got to show better offense and find a way to put some points on the board.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
No sense risking anything there on first down, even though he's still in the pocket. He had a receiver out to his side, so he'll just put that in a spot where the only people who could make a play on it are the trainers and the coaches. Well done.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Wilson. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Warren. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
And a nice gain and a broken tackle along the way. And really, we shouldn't be surprised, should we? That's what runners do, especially the best ones. They break tackles and gain extra yardage.
Here is third down and four.
Here's Wilson.
He's got his target. That's complete.
And he will have a Steelers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And now at this point in the first half, you've got to realize as an offense, you're not going to get it all back in one fell swoop. This is going to be about sustained drives and making sure you finish with points. And that's a good throw there for a first down.
Wilson will throw again. And that is incomplete. 7 seconds remaining.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move them all over the place to try and find good matchups. And they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10. Here's Wilson.
The throw here right sideline falls incomplete.
And that's the knowledge you gain from being in this league for a long time. He's learned the hard way when to give up and fight another down. And that's a smart move to throw it away.
So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. From the left hash, this from 53 yards out. Boswell's kick is good, and that will do it for this first half. So we have reached halftime with our score 10-0 as we send you down to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
And we will not see a return to start the half as this will be a touchback. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive.
Rodgers now on first down. It's Williams on the catch. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. So the completion good for 6 yards, and it'll be second down. Here's Rodgers to throw.
And check down, complete to Hall.
And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds.
A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
Rodgers now to throw. Looking left side, and it's complete. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory.
2 catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first.
Well, that's the kind of play that was lacking all the way through the first half. Maybe this can give him a little bit of a spark because they're not out of this game by any stretch.
Throwing on first down is Rodgers. Wilson's got it complete. Call it a gain of 6 on the play, and it's second down.
On second down, a run with Hall.
And he'll get 4 here down to the 35-yard line.
Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
They'll run with Hall. And this defense not ready for that one as he'll take this down inside the 25.
It'll go as a gain of 11 and a Jets first down.
But they're getting ready to go to work now in prime real estate after that last run. Found his spot and picked up nice yardage, didn't he?
And now he's got him knocking on the door of the red zone. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. On play action, it's Rodgers. And oh, it'll be intercepted.
Picked off by Deshaun Elliott.
Thought he had the pick. Flag comes in for PI, so cancel it out.
Interference. Oh, a killer for them. Thought they had a nice play. Instead, they'll be marching off yardage against them.
So the ball's moved to about the 1 after the penalty. First and goal. Here's Rodgers. Touchdown, Jets!
Jeremy Ruckert
from a yard out.
And the Jets take the interception on defense and convert it into 6 points. So a strong drive here to lead off this third quarter and get them right back in this football game.
And I think we can safely call that a statement drive because they had to be saying, we didn't put our best foot forward in the first half, but we certainly mean business now. Maybe a better term, a prove-it drive. They proved it to themselves that they were ready to go.
Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick.
And Patterson will not return it. It comes out to the 25.
Time for the Steelers offense now to get set for their first possession of half number two.
Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead.
They'll start on the ground with Harris.
And a short pickup to about the 27. It'll be second down.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Harris going to get it again on second down.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down.
Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
Third and eight.
Now it's Wilson. That is caught. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards.
For a tight end, he's got good straight line speed, and on that route, he's often the guy that gets overlooked. Nice job there finding him in stride for really good yardage.
A run with Harris out of the shotgun. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
Kid had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end.
From the 43, here's second down and 2.
Slot man moves right.
Well, they'll fake the jet sweep, and now off play action, it's Wilson.
And they're not able to hook up there. Incomplete.
And when you're in a one-score game in the second half, now's not the time to force the football into places where you shouldn't. And that's a smart decision to just get that one out of there.
So third and 2, this quite possibly 4-down territory, though, if they're stopped.
Trying to pick it up on the ground with Harris. And a good push up front, and he's able to navigate his way down inside the 30. 44 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries.
First downs have not come easy, and neither have runs like this throughout this game.
Absolutely not. He finally felt like, whoa, a sigh of relief. We got something going in the running game. They'll throw on first down with Wilson. He finds his man complete. It's Wilson. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you can get much more balance than this. Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Look pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
And they're going to get him. He's sacked back around the 28. C.J. Mosley able to drop him that time for his second sack of the evening.
This is a little hard for me to compute because I'm watching sack after sack happen, but somehow they're still behind in the game. I would expect all of this defensive pressure to translate to them taking a lead, and thus far it hasn't happened. Time's winding down. They don't want to waste this type of performance from these ace pass rushers.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
Well, partner, guaranteed they approach this play with the idea of making up ground to make third down manageable. Unfortunately, with that incompletion, right back where they started on the last snap. Now they need a big third down play in order to pick up the yardage needed.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And that will be incomplete as well.
Smart move to throw that one away. You're in field goal range, so you definitely don't want to be loose with the ball. And that's great work by this defense to force a fourth down.
Now Chris Boswell for the Steelers field goal try. He made his first attempt, this from 45. Boswell's kick is good. And the lead stretches to 6 here. It's 13-7.
Well, in a close game like this, obviously you want the touchdown, but certainly they will take the three.
And they'll be okay with that, but let's throw a little credit to the defense as well. And I'm just glad this doesn't come down to a debate, right? Which side won, partner? Because the defense, hey, we didn't give up a touchdown. The offense, hey, we put three on the board. Either way you look at it, I think both sides gained something out of that drive.
After the successful field goal try, here's Boswell to send it away.
And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25.
And New York set to take the field.
This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out. Looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
They have not gotten him going at all. Tried to spark something there with a longer throw, unable to complete it.
But you have to keep trying. He's one of their best playmakers. No matter what it says on the scoreboard, you're always trying to get him the football.
Now Rodgers throwing on second down. And his throw here is incomplete.
Well, they approached this drive with a lot of confidence after the last one ended up as a touchdown. But incompletions on their first two throws has them huddling up and trying to figure out a big play here on third down to get their momentum going again.
Now the terrible towels in full force now as the Steelers get set to defend this third and long.
Throwing is Rodgers on third down.
Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he is going to have a Jets first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And maybe that touchdown on the previous drive has re-energized this offense a little bit. They've been kind of sluggish until then, but they're showing signs of life here, and they get good yardage that time and a first down.
And again, it's Rodgers.
A short throw to Conklin, the tight end.
And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. We have played three quarters.
This is the National Football League on EA Sports.
Back now in Pittsburgh. It's Jet football, but they trail here as we start the fourth quarter.
They'll give to Hall.
Boy, shifts past him.
I think that's about as good a 3-yard run as you're going to see. And he actually did with a little bit of flair, didn't he?
The Jets on third down. They've hit 4 of 7. Here it's 3rd and 3. To throw is Rodgers.
Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete.
He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. Well, they only needed a small gain on third down. They end up getting over 30 yards.
Well, as my dad would say sometimes, I'm just scratching my head here trying to figure out what was going on there defensively. How did you lose him in the middle of the field? If you're going to lose a receiver, make sure it's someone on the short side of things, not deep downfield, that can hurt your defense.
Meanwhile, Rodgers' throw taken in by Ruckert.
And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And they'll have a 2nd and 1 forthcoming.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Back to the ground with Hall.
And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. 4 yards on the play. That's going to lead to 1st and goal.
Now that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork and handling a little bit of power, and you find a way to pick up first downs.
They come up on a 1st and goal and most likely 4-down territory as they need a touchdown and the PAT for the lead. On play action, Rodgers. He's got a man, it's his fullback. 3 yards is the gain that time, second and goal.
And the big guy catches the ball out of the backfield, and oftentimes it's quite a surprise to the guys playing defense because not ordinarily thought as a pass catcher, it often works when they decide to dial it up.
Second and goal from inside the five. One of the tight ends comes in motion. Now they'll bring one of their tight ends in motion right. Hall on a give up the middle. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3 yard line. Call it a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal. This is kind of one of those in between plays here, Charles, on third and goal from the two or the three in that area. What do you dial up?
Something quick hitting. You don't have the time for something that develops slowly. It's got to be right at them if you're going to run the football. And if you're going to throw it, something quick, get it out of your hands in a hurry.
Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete. So it's been a long drive. They've held the ball for quite a while. Now what do you do here?
Well, to me, at this stage, after this drive, this close to the goal line, 3 points would be a letdown. I'm going for it here.
Likely the play of the game here, trailing in the final quarter and going for it on fourth and goal. Touchdown! From 3 yards out. And the Jets' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. Big fourth down conversion for the score and the defense. That is a tough pill to swallow.
Big time for them. How about them just deciding to go for it on fourth down? And, oh, okay, forget the field goal, because that looked like an easy 3 points. Yeah, you might have had a defensive breakdown in there, but they pressed the issue and found a way to get it into the end zone. Give them big credit for that.
Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick.
Cordarrelle Patterson to return it, bringing it out of the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. The Steelers ready to take over on offense. And they will be looking to answer the touchdown their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one.
A handoff to Harris to begin the drive. And fights through one man. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled.
62 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line.
Pickens going in motion left. They'll fake it on the jet sweep, and instead a handoff up the middle.
And showcasing those strong legs on that run, getting through one tackle. Now she winds up getting 8 there.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
Under 4 to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. They go play action now. Wilson. And the Jets pressure too much as down he goes.
Jermaine Johnson credited with that sack.
My man, it's been a rough night for that offensive line, and it's only getting rougher. 5 sacks now that they've given up in this contest so far. It feels like the witching hour out here, doesn't it?
Okay, stupid question. What's the witching hour?
Yeah, the witching hour. That's when everything goes haywire late at night.
Looking right side, and that's complete to Watkins. The Steelers picking up 15 yards there and a first down.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
On first and 10, it's Wilson. It's brought in by Wilson. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
All three timeouts plus the two-minute warning. Here's first and 10.
Here's Wilson. Throw left side complete. That's Warren. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Wilson will throw again. Oh, no, he lost the football.
Oh, and one of the linemen on the other side has got it.
Third and long, it's Wilson.
To the sideline and incomplete.
With that incompletion, reality is staring them right in the face. This entire game is down to the next snap.
So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. This for the lead in the final stages. Boswell's kick is good, and they have taken the lead here in the final 2 minutes. Big kick right there to give them the lead in the fourth, but there is still time left for a final drive.
Did they score too soon? Post-game will tell us, right? Depending on what happens on this drive, that's how we'll analyze it. If the other team scores, they scored too soon. If they somehow hold on, they manage the clock exactly right.
After the successful field goal try, here's Boswell to send it away. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25. So Aaron Rodgers and his offense down by two, a minute 54 on the clock. Now their lead is evaporated, but they still have a shot on first down. Now Rodgers, and that's caught by Williams, and they're able to get this one across the 35. This is where, of course, it's good to have a veteran quarterback under center.
You would just be able to put on one of those blood pressure clips, and nothing would be different for him. He's done it many times before, expects to get it accomplished again.
Plenty of time, all three timeouts still remain. Here's first and 10 now. Rodgers' throw going into the hands of Williams.
And this will be good for a pickup of 9 to the 46.
Timing is so important on a route like this because he's going to line up out right and then cut straight across the field. I think the ball might have come out a count or two too late because by the time he was able to secure it, not much of a chance to turn it upfield.
Back to throw, Rodgers. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down.
If they get a game-changing score on this drive, it's going to be because of plays like that. That run was pure heart. Took it himself, found a way to reset the downs, and advance the ball.
This is first and 10.
Rodgers to throw. He's got it to Williams. The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 33 seconds remaining.
Here's second down.
To throw is Rodgers. He's airing it out for Williams. And this is caught. Touchdown. And they've taken the lead here in the final minute.
What an outstanding drive right there to take the lead. And also, Charles, didn't leave their opposition with a whole lot of time on the clock.
Yeah, I like the way that you're viewing this because they did a tremendous job to put themselves in a position to win. But they can't celebrate just yet. They've got to clamp down on any big plays and force them to use up those timeouts without making any headway.
Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. And with time a factor here late, he'll just take a knee and they'll start things out at the 25.
Now it's the Steelers' turn. Trailing by five, 27 seconds to go. They've got to travel the full 75 yards, and time is obviously a huge factor here. First and 10.
Throwing now is Wilson. That is incomplete.
The nice thing is that you've still got all your timeouts, so the middle of the field, that should still be an option, especially if you see the defenders pinching the sideline. You can run a little seam route right here and pick up some nice yardage.
Another try, second and 10 now.
Now Wilson.
That's to Freiermuth. And he'll have a first down, but a great tackle there keeps him from getting to the boundary.
Now a timeout called for by the offense, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the ballgame.
Two timeouts still in their back pocket. It's first and 10.
Wilson to throw.
Here's Freiermuth again.
Now a final chance to stop it here as a timeout comes in with 10 seconds left in the game.
Second and 6 coming up.
Here's Wilson. And that is incomplete, stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go. One final shot now. I'm not even sure he can get it to the end zone, though, from this distance.
That's going to take as much arm as he has, and you actually have to plan for the contingency. Maybe you're playing a tip, try and get someone down who can tip it up and keep it for your own team and try and get to the end zone that way.
One last shot for Wilson. And this will be incomplete. 1 second left to go.
Incomplete pass there is probably the best scenario going, because if he catches the football, clock's probably going to run out in that situation.
One final shot. They'll look to throw. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
That was a long shot, but they did get one final chance to try to score and overcome this small deficit. No touchdown, though, Charles. And that brings this one to a close.
Yeah, I think hope was wearing one jersey and worry was wearing another on the other sideline as that final snap played out. Now, we've seen some incredible plays to win games before, but in this case, I think the distance was just a little bit too great for it to happen here.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com.